Hey guys, welcome to DevOps School. In this video tutorial, we are going to teach you about Jenkins, which is a very popular continuous integration tool. After going through this tutorial, I promise you that the concept and understanding of the Jenkins will be absolutely clear to you. But before that, let me ask you a few things. Are you dreaming of a career with higher pay and more responsibilities? Or are you ready to take your skills to the next level this year? Then start investing in DevOps School certification level courses, which will help you to emerge skills for a wide range of entry-level roles and as well as higher potential future positions. But with thousands of courses online and in classroom worldwide, finding the right one for your career goals can be difficult. You can consider our courses like Agile Developer, Agile QA, DevOps Certified Professionals, Site Reliability Engineering, DevSecOps, and Masters in DevOps Engineering, where you will have access to well-structured, easy-to-follow course content that has been developed and will be delivered by industry professionals. You can join on our training programs globally through online platforms, and if you are looking for classroom workshops, then we have regular sessions available in Bangalore, Hyderabad, Chennai, Delhi NCR, Mumbai, and in Pune. Simply compare our many courses, find the one that suits your style and schedule best, and start today.
So now I'm going to talk about scheduling option. Okay, so how can you schedule using Jenkins? So here there's so many options are there. Let me talk one by one and then I'll show you the demo followed by. Where did you miss me actually? Where I was talking about, can you tell me at what points you missed me out?
You're talking about the triggers.
Okay.
Trigger using command line.
Okay. So here, this is the third option. Yes, you can trigger a job using command line option also. That's not a problem. So here you can build at certain time. Here you can build at certain time, but only if the source code changes. This you can do through the command line also. Fourth option, which you can do, you can trigger this job if other job is triggered. This is a interesting condition. If trigger this job, if other job is triggered. Okay. Triggered. That's a fourth thing. Fifth things you can do. Okay. Trigger a job when there is a push into what? GitHub. Bitbucket. So here, these are the five methods which I have for you. Using that, you can schedule a Jenkins job. These are the five conditions. So are you clear with this conceptually? Can I show you the demo? These are the five ways in which you can schedule the job. Can I show you the demo?
Yes, please.
Yeah. So now let's talk about it. So here, where's my Jenkins? So my Jenkins somewhere is here. And username is Rajesh. Rajesh123. Okay. Now I see here, this is my DevOps School, right? And like that. So now let me start showing you. So when I say at certain time, so go to the any job. Now here, let's say create a one job, job one. Okay, I'm creating a job one, freestyle, click okay. And this is a dummy job. And here scheduling option, you will find in the build trigger options. These are the one. Okay, I'm talking about all these options which you have available. At certain time, that means this option. So here I'm putting up, which you know that. So this option, you already know that, right? This at a certain time, build periodically. Now here I've already given this, how to do that. Again, here pole SCM is the second option. At certain time, but build only when there is a source code changes. So now let me show you first this one and then second this one. So first I will try build periodically. In the build periodically, I'm going to build it every 1 minute. Okay. So star. Every 1 minute. Now here you see automatically it has detected. Okay, so here this is the 1 minute and save it. Now there's no build here. I will wait for a few seconds. Meanwhile, if you have any questions and doubt on these topics, please ask me. So this is the first demo on the build periodically. Okay. Once it will come back automatically, let me show you the second option also. Okay. So here I'll create one more job, job two. Okay. Freestyle project. And now in this, I'm going to try source code changes. So let me tell you here, if there's a source code, then you have to use the source code actually here. So which source code I'm going to use? Same source code. And here, first thing, and here pole SCM. And you see here star, this is the cron format. So you can do this, save. Let me tell you here, I just did set the cron for the polling SCM, but I did not change the source code. So let it happen. By the way, job two automatically, it will trigger once, job one automatically triggered once. You see here, I did not trigger, automatically it has happened. You see here, this is the one, automatically it has happened. Okay, and this will keep triggering every 1 minute. You see second job also automatically got it. But you see here, job two is also getting triggered. And there's a problem here. The problem here is trigger is happening, pole SCM, and okay, this first time it has done it. Now let's check it the second time. Second time it should not happen, pole SCM will not happen because I didn't have any code changes actually. So first time what it has done, it check out the code. But second job, it should not do that. So see, build two has not happened. Meanwhile, job one, you see, two has happened. Third, I'm waiting for it. I have not triggered any of these one. Nothing has happened. Here you see, I'm waiting for the third one because every minute it is set. So this is the third minute it should be. See, still job two, which is a pole SCM. There's no code changes. I have done it. Job one, third one, you see here. So did you understand this option where you can build periodically, blindly it will keep building it and it will keep consuming your source, infrastructure, no matter whether it's the source code changes or not. But in this pole SCM, that logic is there, that intelligent is there, that will build and build only if there is a code changes. So how it is happening? So there's a, you see here, git pooling log. So this will keep pooling it. And if they find the changes, then only it will trigger it. So these are the, this plugin is already, you have installed along with the suggested plugin. So which is making it happen possible. So which command they are running to pool that whether changes are there, you see ls-remote-h. You can see everything in the log, pooling log. Okay, so now can I do this little bit of code changes, source code changes? Let me show you here. So here I go to this here, and one of my favorite file which you have is readme file, which I modify for the demo. So here I modify. Git is not knowing whether it's a fake file or not file. There's a change. Simple. In the Git, we're discussing where did I missed out? Which one I was showing you?
You're updating the readme file in the
Git. Okay. I did. I updated the readme file. And you see here, build number two automatically has come. Now, you get the third build only and only if the source code changes. Now, you did not do anything, but you enjoy those functionality. So guys, this is the two functionality which you have, very powerful, which you can use. It depends on your use cases and requirement. Now I'll teach you third one, trigger using command line. Now this steps is little bit tricky. So now what I was trying to tell you here is, yes. So you saw what is the difference between the build periodically and pole SCM. Now trigger using command line. This is a very interesting feature. And for that, I'm going to set up a job. So now I'll set it up the new one fake job just for this feature, job three, freestyle, click OK. And now here I will go build option. No, trigger option. Yes. And here, do you find it out? This option, which is called this one. build trigger builds remotely from the script. Okay, so here this is the option I was talking about. Okay, so now you have to click here. So first enable it. Step number one, enable this one. Step number one, I'll put it in the sequence so you will not get lost, because this is not that straightforward as it was the last scenarios. So here this is step one. Okay, now step two. Okay, understand this here. Whatever the token authentication token you will keep it, you have to put it in this format. Okay, let's check it out here. Step number two, create a URL for figure. Which URL? So here Jenkins URL, view DevOps school job, job three, build. Now this one, you will have it. The URL is somewhere here. Correct now? This is the URL. So, okay, now done. Okay, so this is the URL. I will validate at least once. Okay, this one. Look at it very carefully. Okay. Okay. URL is correct, and there's no jobs is triggered. Now, this is a parameter to the job. So this parameter, that means you should trigger. Simple. You should trigger. So now this is the parameter for it. So you required a token for it. See here, you must use post method to trigger this build, and you required authentication token, an API token, and it may be blah, blah, blah. Proceed further. So here, this is the run. So you trigger it, and after that, build one has happened. See, so I did this one through, URL, but this is not, I want you to get it done. So here I see second build is in progress. So here what you have to do, this is a token, and token name you can provide this token name. So this, by the way, this token name is optional. So let me put it up in this way. This you can put it up one URL. Now let's say you want to more security in terms of more security, when you want, then you can set up a token. So if I set up a token here, go to the trigger option, and here, where is that? Here, you can set up a token here, authorization token. Without that token, you can trigger this build. So if now this token can be anything. So now for the step-by-step tutorials, I have written a blocks for you, which you can follow later point of the time. Anyways, I'll show you the demo now. And here, and that option is remotely, right? So I will search by remotely how to trigger. Here it is. Okay, all options you have it here in this page, and remotely. Okay, every options you will find it in this this tutorial options you'll find in this URL. Okay, so now I'm setting up a trigger. So what is the token you can give it? So typically I use the one token, which is very interesting token. This one, it's a hash token, which you can use it 40 character. So I'm going to use the same token here. This is a very secret token. If you don't have a token, you'll not be able to trigger this. So save it, done. So I did this one, configure again. I said, remember, I use the token. If those who's having a token, only that person can able to trigger this job. If that person is not having access, without access also, you can trigger a job. So now, can I replace this URL with a token? This is the token. Now, with that URL, you can also do that. So now this is the post action you have to do that. So put it up in the URL. And here, let's check it out the job. Save it. Three, one more time. See fourth, you see that number fourth, it will happen. You see here, post, I'm doing through the browser post action. Okay, fifth option, fifth hit. See here, and refresh, see here, fifth, Okay, are you able to see? Are you in a sync with me? Am I audible and sync screen is in sync with you guys?
Yes.
Okay, great. So now it's like this. But guys, the problem here is, this is not we want to do manually. It has to get it done through the some sort of curl operation or wget operation, something like a post job, like post fix or something. Many ways through programming also you can call this post method. This is the, remember, it's a post method, not a get method, post method. Okay, so what to do in this case? So in that case you can use the curl. So yes, so here you see multiple format is there. You must be seeing the multiple format. You can use one of the format and it'll work for you. Now let me try wget format and curl format both. So here, curl format. This is the curl format. Okay, curl. Let me put it up. Now we have to put it up all these things very clearly. So in the curl, there's a method it's called post. And what is the username? So my username of Jenkins was Rajesh. This is the Rajesh. Okay. Now what is the password? So guys don't get confused. This token is not your token which you set for the job. Again, I'm telling you, this token is not the token which you set it for the job. That is a different token. This token basically for this user token, because if the you are doing the curl operation, so for that here it was logged in. Remember, I was logged in, so you were able to do that. But if you use the curl, then the curl need to log into your Jenkins. So how this will be able to log into the Jenkins? For that, I am going to generate a token. So this I'll put it up in the step number third. Generate user token. Now the question is, how do you generate a user token? Let me show you. So it's very simple. Go to the user, click on it, click on the configuration. You look at my screen here, extreme top right side, here configuration. Now you see here, current token, none of this. For the user, there's no token. So why this token is being used? This token is used for all the automation work. Like if you want to log into the Jenkins and do a lot of automations, you can use this token for authenticated. So this is I'm using for, let's say, some demo and a generator token. Now this token I've generated, I have copied and I have replaced here. Done. Now what is your IP address of your Jenkins? So let me change this here. What is a port? What is a job? So job name is job 3 itself. And what do you want? I made a mistake. Job 3 and build, and this token is the same because I use the same token, so no need to worry about it. By the way, you can use without this token also because you have a super authentication access. You can do whatever you want actually. So can I trigger this job now? So let me do this wonder. So can I show you that number of the job first? Let me save this and go to the Jenkins DevOps school job 3. What is the last number? 5. Now I'll go and git bash. I have to curl need to be there. So in the git bash you have a curl. Okay, and paste it and refresh. See, 6. Can I make it one more? Refresh. One more. It's not come. Why it should come? Okay, let me try one more time. See here, it has come. So it is in pending. So let it go and let it finish and then it will trigger. So some validation. 7. Can I do one more? 8. See, 8. So guys, did you understand the concept of triggering through script, triggering through the command line? Did you understand that? This part? Any question? Guys, any question? am I audible?
No, no question.
Yeah. It's okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, guys. Now I'm going to teach you this one. Trigger this job when other jobs is triggered. Other jobs is triggered. So how can we try this one? So let's create a two fake job. So here I am creating a two fake job, DevOps school. Here job X. Okay. And save it. And job Y. Let me create one more job. Job Y. And fake job Y. Save it. That's all. So I got the two job. So now what I want, whenever job X should be triggered. Understand that zero job. You see that zero build. Job X should be triggered when job Y is triggered and completed. Understand that? That's the condition. So trigger this job when other job is triggered. So how do you configure? So for that, what you have to do? You have to go to the job X, edit, and trigger. And then you have to look for this option. Build after other projects are built. This is equivalent to this one. Okay. So now I will enable this one. And here I will set job Y and save it. Done. Refresh it. Now you see upstream project job Y. Now you see this job Y is not triggered. But remember, I will trigger job X is not triggered. You see here, but I will trigger job Y and you see the magic. So I am triggering the job Y manually. Well, now, and here you see job Y is done. And now can I refresh this? See, job X is also done. So simple, right? So this is the one of the scenario. You have one more scenario when you want this scenario where and only you can use in the use cases. So let's say I'll put it in one of the scenario which I have used it a lot, and that scenario is like, let's say there is a module, there is a project, okay, this is a whole project, and in the project you have a module job one, a module one basically, module two and module three, and there is one common module. So common module, that means if there is the logic is simple. If this common module is changed, then you should have to build this one also, this one also, this one also, right? Because if you are not building with the new common dependent module, then this will not work properly, correct? So in that case, what you can do, the moment this build will happen, then this automatically triggers. So what you can do, you can set in this job and this option. So whenever this is done, whenever it may done in 1 week, it may done in 1 year, it may done in every day, whenever this common dependency job will be doing the build, new libraries will be available, then automatically this will also get updated. So are you able to understand and visualize that case studies where and all you can use this stuff? Guys, are you with me?
Yes, Rajesh.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Guys. So now I hope it is clear so far. So four condition is clear, right? Any questions, any doubts?
No questions.
Okay, now I'm going to ask you, I'm going to show you the fifth scenarios. And this is a little bit tricky. So here I also have to convert into that. So trigger a job when there is a push into the GitHub and Bitbucket. So I'll show you the scenarios of GitHub for the Bitbucket. The documentation is on my portal. You can grab it. So now the question is how? So first, let's understand this requirement. See here, architecture is very important in this. This is your Jenkins and this is your job. This is your GitHub and this is your repo. So this is a GitHub, okay, GitHub, and this is your Jenkins. And I'm sorry, I'm not able to draw properly. So don't mind Jenkins. And this is a job one. Now this is me. I'm a developer and this is my laptop. Okay. Now what happens? I did modification in the code here, and after that I committed in the local repository and then pushed it. So pushed has happened here in the GitHub. So the condition is saying, the trigger a job when there is a push into GitHub. So guys, see here, how this Jenkins will detect this push cannot detect. Who will, in this architecture, who can detect the push? Tell me, when the push happens or not happen, who can detect? Guys, are you with me?
Yes.
Okay. So as part of this architecture, who can detect this push? Am I confusing you?
So when you push to the GitHub, right?
Yes.
Apparently, there is no link between the GitHub and the Jenkins.
Yes, of course. But my question was, whenever you push to the GitHub or Bitbucket or GitLab, the detection of the push activities will be detected by which tool? GitHub, right? Correct?
Yes, correct. Yep.
GitHub. Yeah. So in this case, detection of the Git push activities will be detected by this one. So guys, Jenkins has no idea about this. So who should trigger the job in Jenkins? GitHub should trigger the job. See that. So the movement, see the flow is very simple. Here, whenever user commit and push to the GitHub or Bitbucket, whatever it is, this tool will detect the push activity. And this tool should, again, I'm repeating, this tool should trigger that particular job. Not Jenkins. Here, Jenkins cannot do anything. Jenkins has no control. GitHub, Bitbucket or GitHub will be having control. So did you understand this requirement? Then I'll show you the demo.
Yes.
Okay. So now I'm going to show you the demo. Now this step, which I am showing you, has been documented in article. This article, which you can refer it during doing this, but I don't think so you have to struggle for it, because if you watch me doing it, you can easily do that. Okay, so this is the stuff. Okay, so let's convert into the step one, all the step, and step two, step three, step four, like that. Okay, now this option is equivalent to, let me create a new job here. Job 5. Okay, job 5. And in this case, because of Jenkins is involved with a GitHub, you need to have a user source code also. So source code, I'm going to use it. The same source code, this GitHub repository. Okay. And now in the build trigger, which options? This option. This option. Okay. So now let's set it up. So first thing, one by one, we will go through this. Okay. So first step, install GitHub plugin. GitHub Jenkins plugin, you have to install it. Now, I think this plugin is already there. Let me validate, because this is the previous version of Jenkins. In the new version of Jenkins, this plugin is already there. So let me go. Now the question is how to install plugins. Let's meet issue. Go to the manage plugins. And here you see manage plugin. Don't look any other option. Stick to what you want. Manage plugin option you see. And if you read it very carefully, you can see add, remove, disable, and enabled plugins that can extend the functionality of Jenkins. So without a Jenkins, you can without a plugins, you cannot survive in a Jenkins at all. So here, yes, I will go into the manage plugin. Now, manage plugin has been divided into four parts. One is updates, one is another one is available, third one is installed, and fourth one is advanced. Actually, if you read it, updates, available, and installed tab, by reading itself, you'll get to know, okay, updates where the plugins which is outdated, you will get the notification here. The plugins which is not installed, you will get inside the available, and the plugins which is already installed, you'll get in the inside the installed tab. Okay, so now you see that these are the plugins which is already installed. Now, what is advanced? So advanced, you have a few options. For example, let's say if your Jenkins is running behind the firewall and proxies, you can set up an internet proxies here. Also, if you develop your own plugins in Jenkins and you want to upload it, so you can upload your plugin source here. You can develop your own plugin that's called HPI. This is called, it's a package format. HPI form means Hutchin plugin interface. Okay, so you can develop your own plugin also. And there's a plugin repository available for thus everyone. And you have used it just now unknowingly, whatever it is, from all the plugins which is coming from this API endpoints. Okay, so this is the options which you have. But right now, I have come here not to install, but first to check whether the plugin is there or not. So can I check this GitHub Jenkins plugin is installed or not? So how do we check it out? Installed options. I'll just search GitHub. And here, if I search the GitHub, you see here, GitHub plugins is there. And you see this plugin integrate Jenkins, GitHub to Jenkins. You see this plugin is installed already. So why do we have to install it again? So this is plugin installed. So now step number one is done. You see, I have updated the images also, so you can not get lost, because when you search, actually what happens when you do the filtering in the website, where is that URL? So here, when you do the filter, the UI, and you find multiple confusing plugins also, which may not be related to your work, but still you will find it. So here you can see that that's a for option. Now, second thing is step number second. Configure the GitHub plugin with GitHub account and token. This is the something which you have to do. Now, what is a configure? So guys, understand that very conceptually Jenkins has been designed. One is like, if you want to install tool, then you have to go for manage Jenkins, and you have to go for global tool configuration. You see here, global tool configuration. Okay, you have to use this one, global tool configuration. So here, if you want to install, so global tool configuration. Now, but if you want to configure tool, okay, then you have to use configure system. This is the one, configure system. So this is the only difference which you have. So you have to hard code this one. Very easy to understand that when you want to install global tool configuration, when you want to configure system. So now what is saying, configure GitHub plugin. So any plugins which you installed it, you can install it through the plugin manager, install plugin through install plugins. So for that, you have a plugin manager, plugins manager, and now install tool, you have a global tool configuration, and anything plugins or tool you want to configure it, you have to use the configure system. So here we are saying configure it, not install it. Okay, so configure GitHub plugin with GitHub account and token. This is a spelling mistake here. It should be token. Okay. So now can I do this? Step number two, let me show you. Go to the configure system and look for the GitHub. Here you have so many options. Again, I'm requesting you all, please do not get lost in the something which you don't need it, because Jenkins, you have so many things and many things which you will get it as long as you install more plugins. So don't get lost. Focus on your section, GitHub. And here you have a GitHub. Okay, GitHub, and add a GitHub server here. I'm adding a GitHub server. Now, if you have your own GitHub server, you can put it up this GitHub server, your own APIs and stuff like that. But right now I'm not having my own GitHub server. I'm using the cloud GitHub. So this URL which you have got, it's up to date, it's a current one. Now this I will name it GitHub. Okay, whatever the name, you can give it name anything, but this is important credential. So for this credential, I need to generate a token. So I think some of you might have done it in the past. Go to the github.com. Here, github.com. And go to this setting button. And go to the developer setting button. You see here. And go to the personal access token. And generate a new token. You'll be asked for the password. I'm generating a token for Jenkins demo, and I will give all the access because I don't want you to get lost in the these checkboxes, explaining these checkboxes, because it will take longer time, and that's not our topics also, right? So just everything, all the permission you give it. This is the wrong practice you are doing, but I'm just asking you to do that because once you want to customize it, you can do it later on. So guys, this is a token. I got it. Okay, this is the token. I got it. So this token is ready for me. So this token, this token have access to modify any of my repositories or my stuff. Now let me tell you here. Right now you all are using my Jenkins and you don't have a permission. So what you can do, you can fork my repository and then you can generate a token. So you have a control over your repository. Understand that? Very simple. So now here I got the token. Configure. So can I go and configure it? So here, add Jenkins. Here, what I will do, username. What is the username? My username is devops-school. And what is the token? My token is, by the way, it's not a password, it's a token, right? So here, GitHub app. Here. Okay. And just a second. Secret. I'm using for token secret text. Just a second. So this option, it should be with a token. There's an option, but I'm saying, can I adjust somewhere else also? Secret ID. ID, I think this also we can use it. GitHub app ID, I don't have it right now. And certificate, there is no question about it. Okay, let me check that in the previous version of Jenkins, which you have used it. And here you see, I generated here and credential GitHub. So okay, let me try once. Basically that token option is I cannot locate it. So I will do one thing. I'll go for the secret text, and secret text is this one. I will give the ID GitHub and description also I'll give it a GitHub. ID is important, add it. Now here I will select and I will check whether it's able to connect or not. And you see here, credential verified for user DevOps school and rate limit 499. That means it worked. So this is the second thing we do that. So remember I did this one, I use that text, secret text, which it worked for me. So here, configure the GitHub plugin with GitHub account and token, which I did it. So do you have any questions so far? And then save this. Do you have any questions, guys?
I'm okay.
Okay. Now, third step, what we will do, now we'll configure the job. That is the job. So now let's do this, configure the job. So see here, configure Jenkins job on which you want to push trigger and should be effective. See here, I can push any repository, but it's not like you should build every job. No, it should not build every job. I want to build only job 5, I guess, right? So here you have to configure. So here, let's configure. You know that trigger option. By the way, I've selected the source code management. Yes, is there. Build trigger. And now you select this one. Okay, this is the one. You fill this by following this URL. You see here, GitHub URL, you have to feed this one also. So here GitHub URL, which is here, GitHub URL. What is the project? You have to feed your project. It will not work with my project, remember, because you do not control my project. Okay, this is the one thing, and this is the second thing you have to enable. All this print screen, I have given it here also and here also. Okay, see here, first, second, third. That's all. Guys, you're done with it. Now, save it. Done. Now, in the older version of Jenkins, there was one more things which you have to do. But right now, this is not needed. This is not needed. Okay, so that is not needed at all. Okay, so can I go and check this one more time just to make sure that, because sometimes they have changes also. So this is done. And step number four, this is not needed, which I tried last time, but still I'll validate because changes may happen ad hoc basis anytime. So configure webhook on GitHub for specific repository. So basically webhook has been deprecated recently. So I'll check that option. So this, because this is the github.com is a cloud version. In the last time I have used the enterprise version, which was hosted actually. So different version, different implementation. So I'll just check this one. My repository, we go to the setting and go to the webhooks. And webhooks is there. Yes, this has been deprecated. Oh no, it's here. It's there right now. Webhooks. Can I add a webhooks? Now guys, here you have to be very careful. Here you have to be very careful. So okay, so you have to follow this secret. So now guys, please hear me out very clearly. This step four is a little bit complicated and we make lots of mistake here only, and I get lots of emails saying that they stuck here only. So what is this? Very simple. First let me change this and then I'll explain it to you. Now what happens, see that, understand the architecture. When developer push the code to GitHub, now GitHub should trigger which job. So basically GitHub cannot trigger a job. GitHub trigger one of the URL here, and this URL is intelligent to trigger that specific job which is been pushed actually. And this is called, this URL is powered by the plugin of GitHub plugin, which you installed it. So here, how can you access this URL? And that plugin's URL, you can access it at this port. Okay, this port. And this you have to hard code GitHub webhook. Okay, this GitHub webhook. You see here, you have to be very careful. I have written also here, add a webhook payload URL. Leave secret input is not required, and this one, because secret you have already given it, so you don't need it. So you have to do that. So now can I do this very carefully? This is the place we have to make a mistake. Also, one more thing I have noticed last year, if you leave this one, probably it will not work. But sometime again, you have to keep checking this option. So none of, like, everything as it is, you have to get it working. Sometime because of the release change of the GitHub or plugins or Jenkins, some of the configuration may change in the future. So you have to keep trying this way. I do the same way actually. So here I go to my URL and leave it as it is. And here I select push. Just this trigger should happen the moment there is a push happen in this repository. And add webhooks. Simple guys, I did it. It's active. You see, Now, can I do the push? And for doing the push, I have to now use my command line tool. So I'm in my desktop. Remember, I'll show you the job first. Job 5, no build has been done. And you see the GitHub URL has come here. You see here, everything automatically has been set it up. So powerful, Jenkins is so powerful, everything. It can be done with the help of the minimal activities. So now I'll go to the E drive. Okay, and after that E drive, I'll create one directory, DHL, and go into the DHL. And here I am going to clone this code. So git clone. Okay, now I have to go inside this hello world. And after that, I have to set the username. So git config user dot name. It's a git stuff, Rajesh Kumar, and git config user dot email. It's a new repository we have to set once. DevOps at the rate of Rajesh Kumar dot xyz, and git. I have to modify some file, right? So which file I should modify? Of course, readme is the culprit, is the file to go. And I modify something here, something, some text, some random text, up, up, up. I just save it. Git status, you see this file has been modified. Git add dot and git commit. This is for demo for GitHub integration. GitHub integration, and then git push and origin master. I'm pushing it, remember. And let me show you here. There is no jobs for time being. I'm pushing it. Push has completed, and now refresh it. See? Understand that? Did you understand this?
Yes.
So guys, it's so many features you have. It's, you know, you decide what kind of automation you want to have it. And this is the feature, every steps you have it in this tutorial. Again, if you feel in the future, this get outdated, I don't try every once in a 2 months or something like that. So if you feel these are any of my tutorials get outdated, it's not working, please drop me an email. I will update it. And I'll notify this, because the technology is changing every day. Every week we have a Jenkins new releases, patches, GitHub also new releases, plugins also keeps coming and going. So it's like that. Make sense? Okay. So now I have completed the scheduling part. Remember, see, Jenkins has how many features? Jenkins has way to automate manual step, I taught you. Scheduling, I taught you. Now, next topic would be immediate feedback. This is a pretty large topic. I will take a little bit of more time. And then finally, integration tool. This is a huge topic, actually. Trust me, huge topic. So we'll continue with this one, and then integration tool. So did you understand that? Any questions, any doubts? Any questions, any doubts? Guys, are you there? Am I audible?
Yes, yes.
Yes, no questions.
Okay.
Okay, so there's one question from Chris. I think our enterprise GitHub don't have a webhook. I can't find it, but it has the token. So yes, GitHub webhooks you will find to the repository. If you can't find it, then there must be some other way to integrate it. So if you tell me your GitHub enterprise version, then I can help you with it. Okay, so that is our thing. And where you got stuck, which step you followed, which you missed it, If you tell me that detail, and I can tell you, because the implementation will not be having so much of differences, except one or two steps might change. Okay, Krish? Krish, are you there? Okay, yeah. Okay, guys. So now let's have one tea break. I badly need coffee. Yes, Krish, I cannot hear you. Yes, that's for sure. I cannot hear you. I can see your chat, but I cannot hear you anything. Okay, so now let's have one tea break, one coffee break. And then once we come back from the break, I will give you time, you to do all this stuff one by one. And after that, I'll move on to the scheduling part. Feedback part. Okay, feedback is lots of options are there also we need to discuss. Okay. Okay, guys, so I'm updating the notes. Those who wants to continue doing lab, please do that. I'm updating the notes. Please remember that notes will be there forever. So you have to have a fab of it. So I'm updating the same notes which I'm maintaining for you. So now, guys, this is the third topic which I'm going to teach you, and that is how to enable immediate feedback in Jenkins. That's the third pillar, right? You use Jenkins for immediate feedback of whatever you do. So now, how do we get this immediate feedback? So one of the method which we have to receive the feedback, and that is one of the is like an email. Okay. Our second options which we have is like a chat. Third option which we have is like you can also get pager and stuff like that. And fourth option which you have is like dashboard. Dashboard, typically you call it pipeline. So pipeline, you create it, you integrate the jobs and stuff like that. So we'll work on the dashboard front. Now here, when it comes for the email functionality, there's a two plugins are available. Okay, so let me show you here. Two plugins are available. One plugin is login to Rajesh 123. So now here, manage plugin, and here go and check the installed one. Now if you see here, just search for mail. Okay. You see here there's one plugin which is called email extension plugin. Okay. That's the one plugin which you have. This is advanced version of it, and there's one more plugin which you have somewhere, mailer plugin. It's the basic version, now this is the way. So you have a mailer and you have an advanced. Now these two plugins, how to get it, already is installed actually. So if you go to the DevOps pool, now let's create one job for this, and let's create email basic. Okay, email hyphen basic digital projects, click OK. Now you want to drop an email. So you have to go to the post bill action. And here in the post bill action, you have so many features actually. If you look at this here, see, so many features are there. Don't get lost in that many features, because all are available because of certain reasons, certain plugins. So I will stick to my objective. I want the email, basic email. So here you see, this is the basic email functionality, email notification. This is the one, okay? Now you set this email here, you'll get it. Now this have a very limited option here, send email for every unstable build. Or here there's a second option which you have right now is send separate emails to individual who broke the build. So basically it's a very limited functionality. Now this is the one which you have available powered by Mailer plugin. Now if you go for the advanced plugin, email extension plugin, then you have to use this one, editable email notification. And this is a very advanced, let me tell you here. You can say from, you can decide the recipient list, you can put it up. This is the variable is been used. To list, content type, subject you can decide. Content what you want to put it up, you can customize whichever you wanted. Attachment, you want to attach the build dog and all. And again, this is not the end of this option. Advanced setting, so many other options. See, you can execute some pre-send script, post-send script, add some groovy class path. You can trigger something, failure on developers or culprits, recipient list, requester, and so many options are there. Okay, so you can enable these two plugins based upon your requirements. Now, the question is how these plugins will be able to send an email. So now emails is powered by SMTP. Remember, SMTP, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. Yes, the email which was getting it in the morning, that was done through the system. That system Linux has sent that email to you. So basically Jenkins, in absence of SMTP server, Jenkins send that request to your server's system to drop an email, and system utility send that email because my server was in public domain, and so it sent that email. But right now we'll set up SMTP. So how we get up SMTP? So for that, I will just leave it as it is. Go to the Jenkins. Any options which I said very specifically, any options which you want to configure, not install, configure. Manage Jenkins, configure system. Click on it here. And again, you will find so many options. Don't get lost. Stick to your goal. I need SMTP. SMTP. And here you see extended email notification SMTP server you have for this plugin. And for the basic one, you have somewhere in the down. See here, email notification. For if you want to use this one, if you want to use the basic one, you set here SMTP. If you want to use the advanced one, you set this is SMTP. It's up to you. So now, how do we get SMTP? So now let me get one SMTP with the help of AWS. So here, I go to AWS. I'll quickly grab one SMTP just for the demo purpose, nothing else. Okay, so here I'll go for the Ireland region. That's where I have a mail server set up. SES, we call it. There's a service which is SES for the setup, the SMTP server. So simple mail service. Now I'm setting up one SMTP setup. Now this is the SMTP server. Here, this is the SMTP server. And now I have one credential I have to create. Now this is Jenkins. I'll name this Jenkins. This has been used for the Jenkins. Now this is the credential. Now let me tell you, after this use, I have to delete this, otherwise it will be creating a problem for me. So yes, be mindful about this. So I'm setting up this one. So can I go ahead and set it up now? So here, now let's set it up in the basic one. So here SMTP server, this is the one. Here I'll go for the advanced option. I'll try to set it up authentication. And what is the username? So my username is here. Password. This is the one. Now use SSL or TLS. I'll go for the SSL. SSL 465, TLS 578. You can use it. The port number, this one. And okay, test configuration, Rajesh at the rate of SCM Galaxy. Test it. Here, you see, sir, what is the error? See here. If you read the error, you will get it. Actually, here it says that email sent. See this email. This is the email address. Okay, nobody at nowhere. Okay, email address is not verified. So that means this SMTP does not recognize this email address. Now you must be wondering from where it is coming. So this is a from list. If you go up a little bit up slowly, it's coming from is coming from.
Thanks for watching. To watch our complete session, enroll for our premium membership. Click onto the join button and enroll yourself with the best suited option.
Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries. We will reply to them at the earliest. Want to study further? Subscribe to our paid membership to get a deep dive into each and every topic. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to our DevOps School channel and hit the bell icon to learn more. Keep learning.